Hello students, welcome back. I am Professor Prithish Chubey. Brought you another exciting topic of a concept, DC machines, from basic electrical and electronics engineering subject. We already had a discussion on a DC series motor. In continuation with the same line of action, we are going to discuss about DC shunt motor. What we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss about an equivalent circuit of DC shunt motor and how that particular equivalent circuit can be used to solve a numericals related to DC shunt motor that we are going to discuss in today's session. Okay, now let me proceed. Now, again, what is shunt combination? Shunt is nothing but both the winding. Again, just to recall, in case of any motor, there are two windings. One winding act as a conductor and one winding act as a magnet. So this is an armature winding act as a conductor and another winding which act as a magnet known as a field winding. So this is the field winding F and this is the armature winding A. And this is an applied voltage V across it. Now here comes a concept that both these windings are connected in parallel. Parallel is also called as shunt. Shunt is another name to the parallel because this is shunting these two terminal, field winding is shunting these two terminal, that's why this combination is known as a shunt combination in which armature and field windings are connected in parallel, right? Now in continuation with the same, can I draw an equivalent circuit of this? Yes, again very easy to draw that because we already know the equivalent circuit of armature and equivalent circuit of a field winding. Now let me draw an equivalent circuit of a armature. See, this is the very first component VB, that is nothing but brush losses. In many cases brush losses is very small, so that's why it can be ignored. We already discussed it in a DC series motor. Then second component is RA, that is a resistance of armature winding because it is made up of a copper and copper do have some resistance. Then third component is EB, that is nothing but back EMF. Again, polarity of back EMF is same as that of polarity of VB. So this is about an equivalent circuit of armature. Okay, any question up to this point? No, very simple because we already did it. Now, equivalent circuit of field winding. Equivalent circuit of field winding is very, very, very easy because there is only one resistor RF, right? Because equivalent circuit of field winding is just one resistor, there is no concept of a brush losses or there is no concept of a armature back EMF, right? So this is an equivalent circuit of a field. Now, voltage applied across or to this particular circuit V is shown over here. V is an applied voltage to this circuit. Now, let's generate an equation of this. But before doing that, we need to understand one very important concept in case of a shunt motor. If this is a current I, total current I, then that current I is coming to this particular junction. Let me call this junction as a X. At junction X, that current is further getting divided into two branches, right? So this branch is IA and this branch is IF. Why I have given a name as a IA and IF? Because this is an armature branch and this is a field branch. So that's why current flowing through field winding is IF, field current, and current flowing through armature winding is IA, that is armature current, right? Now from this particular figure, at point X, if I apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, then I can say that total current I is equal to IA plus IF. Don't forget that energy is neither created nor destroyed. Like that, current cannot be created, cannot be destroyed, and that is the reason IA, total current, is further getting distributed as an IA and IF. So this is the first equation that we will be needing to solve any equation or any numerical related to DC shunt motor. Now in this case, let's apply a KVL. Again, I'm considering this as a direction of a current because this is positive terminal of applied voltage and this is negative terminal. So current I, let me call this particular current as a I2 and let me call this particular current as a I1, right? Now let me generate an equation of for this particular loop and for this particular. Let's start with this loop, left hand side loop, and I'm going to start from point X, right? So now let's proceed. Minus VB, correct? Because this is a constant and there is a voltage drop, right? Then minus IARA. Now you can see that I can write I1 also, but you can see that in this particular line there is only one current flowing and that current is nothing but IA and I1. Means in this case I1 is the current which is a IA current for this particular branch, whereas for this particular branch I1 is nothing but a subtraction of a IA and IF. IF is not at all flowing through this particular branch, so I can directly write it as an IA also, right? So IARA, then minus EB. I'm considering negative sign because voltage drop is voltage is drop, that's why it is negative. Now coming to this branch, there is no current, and now going on this branch. While for this particular branch, just try to understand there are two current, so that's why I will write it like minus IARF plus IFRF, because RF is going, IF is going in this direction and I is going in this direction, that is from bottom to top, and IF is going from top to bottom, right, is equal to zero. So this is the first equation. Now let me apply and KVL to this second loop. So this will be equal to minus IFRF plus IARF, correct? Then here, then this is when I come to this point, this will be minus to plus, means what, voltage is raised. So plus V is equal to 0, right? So these are the two equations. So this is equation number 2 and this is an equation number 3, right? But you can see one thing, this is a parallel circuit. So voltage applied across this particular two point is same as that of voltage applied across this two point. Means how much will be a voltage dropped across this particular resistance? It is equivalent to V, right? So I can replace this equation 2. I can rewrite equation 2 as minus VB minus IARA minus EB minus V is equal to 0. So means this particular part is equivalent to V. You can see that this is nothing but equation 3. You can simplify an equation 3 and substitute that particular value in equation 2. So equation V will be IF, so IFRF minus IARF is equal to V. So if I put it over here, this is V. So from equation 1 and 2, equation 2 and 3, from 2 and 3, from equation 2 and 3, this equation is generated. And this is the most important equation, equation number 4. Equation number 4 is very, 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 very important. So equation number 4 along with equation number 1, and next equation is EB. EB is equal to P phi NZ divided by 60A. So these are the three main equation, equation number 1, equation number 4, and this is equation number 5. So these are most important equation. If you have these three equation with you, you can solve any numerical related to DC series and DC shunt motor, right? Now let's proceed and try to plot a characteristics of DC series and DC shunt motor. Till then, enjoy this session. Thank you.